Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Yulari, and today I wanted to share with you all the tutorial for the Polaroid mini album that I shared in my past video. Now, in the description box below will be a link to my blog where I put the pattern, the template for this mini album. Now, in the template, you will find this piece that will come like this. Let me show you. It will come like this, and this is the base. So this, it will create this element here, this front cover here. Now I put it in the mirror side, so I could highlight for the other side, which is something that you can do. So is this piece over here, just put it around, or you can use it like this. So is this piece over here, and all I did was that I create in the file as well is this pieces here that creates the checker element of the cover, and you put this. I cut this on chipboard. Now I use my Cricut to cut all my pieces. You can download it on your cutting machine, or you can print it out and you cut it by hand. So this is in chipboard, and I just color it with acrylic paint in white, so I don't see that a cartoon color inside where my checker element is. So you will put this in top, and then you have these pieces that you will cut in design paper. So you will cut this twice, one in chipboard and one in design paper, so you will have the cute part to cover that. And then you have these other pieces, and this goes in top of it, creating two marshmallows there. So here I already have my checker, and all I have to do is glue this piece in top of it, and it will create two marshmallows for my Polaroid mini album cover. You see? So that's what it is. Now, you see the stitching is decorative purpose only, and with the difference of my checker element, because I don't have acetate, I had to use these refill pages from Paper Studio. And what I found was that my checker wasn't gluing with my glossy accent, and so I had to stitch it because it wasn't gluing. So I don't know, maybe you have better luck than me, or you have another glue that is a lot better to glue these checker elements. Or if you have acetate, it's a lot more easy to glue. You can use double side tape for the acetate and all that stuff. Anyway, so I had to stitch it. What I did was, in the base, I used a chipboard. I cut two pieces, one in the design paper and one in chipboard. So my shaker has a depth. So here I use this corrugated cardstock, and this is from the supply store. And it's just in the back is white, in the front is white, and in the back is in this color, and it's like a corrugate in the inside. And that's how I cut my cover here. So what I did, I stitched that sleeve, I stitched it in the base. Again, you don't have to stitch it. It's because my glue wasn't glued in there, so I had to stitch it because it was the only way that I saw it was going to work. Now, I stitch in one side and I stitch in the other side, so I made like a clear side. The front part I already glued it to the base, so you cannot see it, but I put one sleeve here and one sleeve in the other side, so it's a clear page. Now, this part over here is not in the file because this was done while after I had done the file. This is was something that I was thinking how I'm going to decorate. And then I remember these umbrellas where you put in your picnic area that you decide to eat in the picnic session, and it has these umbrellas with these little tinges there. So I remember that, and I decided to use mine and do one of those. I did it in both sides because again, this is the front, and when you flip the page, it's gonna see in the other side. So I don't want it like seen like this, you see? So I wanted in both sides so it would cover the back side of the other. So that's what I did. Now, again, you will print or do one in chipboard and another one in design paper. So here it is, the piece. Now, I stitch the paper off, not with the chipboard like I did here. You see, it's just the paper. Again, this is decorative only. You don't have to do it. I just love stitching. I love the touch that it gives and all that stuff. Now, this is the back side. I don't put in my file, in my blog. You will not find this. Why? Because this is just an 8 by 6 inches piece of cardstock, the chipboard, for the back side. So it will be like this. You see, so because it was just a simple cut, I don't add it because it was not needed. So this is the back side. Now for the spine, I did something that I learned from Alasne. I love her videos, her YouTubes and everything. So she did a basket, and she did it with a picnic basket. So she did the bread, the thread, that thing that you do. And it's like this, and then the other one in the top, right? And then you start doing this over and over and over again. One in top, one down, one in the top, one down. And then you do the same thing with other strips, like here. So I can show you a little bit how it is. Like this, and you continue like this, you know, one up, one down, one up, one down, like this. So that creates this pattern. Now, because mine wasn't perfect, I had holes in there, you see? Some pieces, they move and everything, and so I don't want that to show up, so I put fabric in the back, so it will cover those blank spaces, and you will not notice. Because if I don't show you won't see them. So then I just stitch again to decorate, and here I glued it. I use Fabrita. I love this glue. It glues everything, fabric, paper, wood, anything. I love it. So I glued it here, and I put just these ones here, these clips to hold it, and then I just went to bed, and it was already dry, and then I just stitch on top of it to decorate the top. So then when I put this, this is the base of the binding, and this is a 2.5 inch by 6. So what I did when I glued it in top of it, and then obviously when I glued it, I bend these edges here, so you will cover that cartoon color here in these edges. That is the purpose of it. Now you will score at the end of each side, so you can do this fold. You see, so it's manageable when you glue the base of the album and you put it together, it will already have the shape. So this is what it is. Now for the spine here, you need to have in mind the distance between here, this thickness here, because this goes connected to this. So you don't want something that will show or like this, because you know it will look very bad. So you have to have in mind to leave just enough space to cover. You see, you don't see it through. So you have like a thread in there. Okay, let me cut that one a little faster. I don't saw that. So yeah, so that's what you have to do. Now, in this side over here, you don't have to worry about it because this is not a shaker. So you don't have to worry about it, you see? You're gonna put this here, and then you cover this with the sandpaper, and you're gonna see that again. So that is very easy. The back side, you don't have to worry too much. It's just the front side. Now, in the file, you will find this part, this element there. Now, it comes like this, and it cut this piece, pa 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 pam, and you create a shaker. This piece, well, you can do whatever you want to do with the embellishment, something. So it came like this. With this piece, you create a shaker. Now, again, because I'm using those pages sleeve, I had to stitch it. I stitch it to the paper because the first time when I stitch it with the chipboard, what happened was that because this is a corrugate in the inside, it flattened. It flattened. It was very bad, and I had to do it again. So unless you have a stiff chipboard piece instead of this kind, there is like a corrugate in the inside, like a hollow in the inside. Don't stitch it because it's just gonna flatten your chipboard and it's gonna be bad. So that's what I had to do, is to stitch it to the design paper. Now you have a base for that as well. You can use it. In this case, I will not. I'm not going to use it because I want to display this design. That's why I created like this, because I want to display this pink blank kind of thing. So I'm going to glue my shaker here. Now, you see the hole here? I use again the golden paper to cover that cartoon color there, and I will do the same thing in the outside. I haven't done it yet, but I'm gonna do it. So this goes here. These are the decorative purpose. You don't have to, so it's up to you if you want to do it or not. Okay, so I think I covered all the bases, so let's go start it so we don't take too long, and I will go explaining all the other pieces step by step. Now we're just going to start with the base. Now here I'm going to leave a space, and I create these rulers here with my Cricut, and these are for mini albums. It's super easy to create the spaces with the mini albums, the corners and all that stuff. Now I'm going to leave a quarter of an inch of space, and then I'm going to glue my base. Now you have to make sure, because this spine is shorter than the base, you have to be very careful. You have to center this and then create the same space between, like this one here. You see? Create the same distance here from this. Now I'm going to glue this one first. This I need to decorate, to cover with something before I glue it here. So let's get started with this one here. So I guide myself with the ruler, and then I make sure that I have it where I want to, like this. Then I'm going to use, you can use double-sided tape, you can use the fabric tag. I love fabric tag, I have said it many times. I love fabric tag, and that's what I'm going to use. So I'm just going to I'm guiding myself with the top of this line so I know where I'm going to do it. Then I just take this off and it's there. Now we are going, I'm going to cover the back side, and I'm going to use this design paper, and I think it's super beautiful. So I'm going to put it like this. Okay, so I'm going to use my tools. I create these rulers on my Cricut so it will be easier for me. And then let me use this side over here. Okay, this is perfect. So it will have like the same distance everywhere, so I don't have to use all that paper. Now I'm going to glue this chipboard base to my base here. I forgot to put my ruler. See how far I want it. Okay. Okay. Now I glued it there. Now you don't have to do this next step. I'm going to stitch it. But I'm going to stitch it because I already stitched the other parts, and I want it to be, you know, to look like it's a whole piece. I don't want like one piece stitch and the other. No, I don't like the look of it. So I'm going to stitch, and you need to just to wait my wet glue to dry so I can stitch it and not damage my machine. Okay. Okay, going to stitch after I glue these edges. I forgot that I had to do that. So you see this ruler, the idea here. So you put that ruler to the edge of that corner there, so it will let you like half an inch, not half an inch, a 1/8 of an inch space. So when you fold the edges, it will be very nice. So that's what I'm doing here. So I'm just using my cutter in here. Now I need to change my cutter tip, but I cannot found it. I cannot found it. And my craft stores here are all closed still, and I don't like to buy Online, because I mean, I can buy online, but it's not the same thing when you buy small things in the craft store. So yeah, so anyway, so just like that, and then you just fold it, glue it, and you know, do the same thing that you always do. Just remember, when you are doing a mini album, you always glue first the longer size. The large size is the first one that goes. Now, don't be afraid for my glue. Yes, this is like over here, but I still have a new one. I got the new bird glue, but I'm just, you know, using everything before I had to drop it to the garbage. So yeah, so first the longer side and then the shorter size. Okay, I'm gonna do this off camera and then I will be back. Okay, I already covered my back and I use the golden cardstock to decorate the edge. Now I'm going to use my fabric tab to glue the base here. Have to remember the space that we that quarter of an inch that we are leaving. Yep. Here. Okay. So then now we have to alignate this to the other base. Okay. And it has to be very, you know, in the bottom it has to be very equal, because when you stand it, you know, you want it to be standing up nicely. Now I just need to use the golden thread for this other side as well. Okay, so now that we are going to let the base dry for a while. So we are going to continue with the spine now. I have this piece and I'm gonna do this now before I put this away. And this is 4.5 by 6 inches. That is it's just a little bit shorter than the base in here on the spine. And this is to cover this ugliness over here. So I'm going to erase that. Remember, it's 4.5 by 6. Now you are not going to see this part over here, because here is going to be the binding of the pages, but this is going to be all covered, but I don't want this ugly size here. So I'm just gonna put this part over here. Now what I did was I got the paper and I scored what is the 2.5 inch that is my spine. So it will be easier, you know, it will be already fold and everything. So again, let me show you. So you're gonna score a 1 1/8. So you score, and then you do, you remember that it's 2.5 inch the score, the binding. So then you score that, the rest of it. Oh my God, like this. It's 1 1/8, and here is 3 3/8. Something like that, and just score. Just make sure that the paper that you are going to make this 4.5 by 6, that the spine is 2.5. That is the important part here. And this over here, this the flaps, you can make it this shorter than the base here. It doesn't matter. Just try not to make it too long, because it will show up in the shaker. But all this just to cover this part over here, so it looks pretty. And you see, I'm reusing a piece of paper. So that's all it is. It's actually to cover the ugliness. You don't have to do it. I do recommend it to do it, because when we are going to glue our pages, we want to cover these parts over here with something more pretty. And what more pretty than a clean cardstock, you know, a white clean cardstock. So let me Just trying to center this, okay. And that's it. So we're gonna put this to dry. I'm going to use my score line, my score tool, to just to, you know, to reinforce this. So it's very nicely glued. Remember, the only thing that you will see from here is a little bit of the white edges here, because this part over here will be covered by the binding of the pages, so you will not see it. It's just to make it look like more decent, more pretty. So okay, so because the paper was already scored, so it's more easy. Now we let this to settle on one side. Now you're gonna need these strips of paper. And these strips are the base of the pages, is what is going to bind our pages for the mini album. Now, this is a 2.5 inch. You're gonna score a 1/2 inch and a 1 inch. So it will leave 1/2 inch of space for you to decorate your pages, and it's not going to be like too fit together. It will give you like that space to breathe the pages, and so you can decorate them. So now you're gonna have 4 of them. That's four is the ones that I did. If we are able to fit another one, then we will know, but for now I'm just gonna put 4 of them. And then I made this strip. This is just golden cardstock that is less than 1/2 inch, like, you know, this 1/2 inch here in the center is less than that. And the other one is even smaller than the golden strip, so it will decorate the center, so it's not that white cardstock. So all I'm gonna do is glue it in there. Now I stitch it, but I glued it first and then I stitch it to decorate it. You don't have to do it, you just can skip all this step, but I think it looks very pretty when it's with strips. You can use a 2-color-based strips, like I did here. I did the golden and then I use this blue base, and then I glue them together, and all you have to do is just glue them. Now make sure, because this is very important, make sure that the same distance from the bottom, and so when you fold them, it will decorate the back side of the cardstock here. It will decorate it as well. But so let's go ahead, and what I'm gonna do is that I'm just going to use the glue in the base of the strips, so it doesn't glue my other part, my leftover parts. Okay, and then center it here. So you're gonna have this. You see, this is what I need right now for you to do. You just glue these strips. If you're gonna make them, if you are not going to make them off, that's completely fine, but it does decorate it very pretty when they have them. So yeah, so remember, it has to be less than 1/2 inch. That is the score lines in the center, so it will not be too cramped. So that's why, so you can fold you see your flaps without problem. You see, you can flap them. It will not have no problem there. So you will do the same thing to the other one. So yes, so let's go ahead. So now that you have the strips done, you're gonna cut a piece of paper that is going to measure 2.5. Remember, 2.5 is the size of our spine, and then going to cut it by 8. 8 is the longest of our mini album. And so like this, you see, is the length of our mini album base. So that's what you're going to cut. Now you're going to center this piece over here. I know, because it's white with white, you cannot see it. So let me, okay, just decorate the edge so you can see the how I'm going to position this slip. So you're gonna fold this one here, and you're going to glue it at the edge of this page. Now you have to center it that the same that you will left here in the top, you will left in the bottom. So you have to be very careful with that. So I'm going to try to center this the best possible way. So that's what you're gonna do, and then you're gonna line up all the rest with this page, so they will be all very well Line up together, so it's no one here, one there, not all in the same place, in the top and in the bottom. Okay, so you're gonna put it, this one in the top here, and then the other one like this, and that's how we create the spine for the binding of the pages. Okay, so I found that you will need 5 of these strips. So I made an extra one, I added already. So you're going to have this like this, okay? Now this one and this one, you're going to cut it out because this one we don't need. So I'm gonna use my cutters to do so. So you will have this, okay? Now, before we do anything else, we are going to cut this an angle so it will be easy for us to insert the pages. It doesn't have to be much, it's just a little bit angle in here. Nice. This is so bad to do it so far from the, when you try to do it in camera, because you are in certain distance, you cannot see very well. So you're gonna do the same thing the other side. Now for the pages as well is on my blog. There you will find the file of it and all of that. So you can print it out or you can use your cutting machine. You scan and cut and cut it out. So let me bring them here. So until before we put the pages and all the stuff, you see all these long strips that was left over from this base strip. You're gonna put it in the back and glue them. I'm just gonna use the glue art like this. Sorry about the noise. Okay, so you put them in the back, and then I'm going to put a clip so it will hold them while it gets dry. Okay, let me move this one here and here. Okay. So while we wait for that to dry, now the pages, I had the file as well, is in the blog. It's a printable, you can print it out, you can put in your scan and cut and cut it out, or in any other cutting machine, you can upload them. There are a lot of tutorials for it. So anyway, so I use again my Cricut to cut my pieces. I cut 4 of them, but then I also cut them on design paper so I could cover back and front. Now, because I'm going to use my design paper, I'm going to show you, well, I'm going to explain to you how what I did. So you see this here, the design paper is in the front page here, but if you do it for the back side, is going to congruent. So what I did was that I print with the paper like this in my mat, you know, print cut. I put the paper upside down and then cut the pattern again. So what does this does? It creates like the back side like this. So when I put it here, my back and my front have design paper, you see? So that's what I did. One with the design paper looking in the top and the other looking down. So that way you have 2 papers, design papers in the back and front. So that's what I did. So here is in only white cardstock for the base. So what we're gonna do, I'm gonna take these clips. So what we wanna do is that you're going to take the page. Now this is heavy cardstock, 110. And then you see our pages here, it came like 2 flaps. You're going to put the page in between like a sandwich, and you're going to center it in there. You see, like this. And you're going to glue them. Now you can use tape, you can use wet glue, you can use whatever you wish. I'm going to use wet glue here. And that is how you're going to glue all your pages. You can glue one first and then the other, so the glue doesn't get dry right away, because this glue is a fast dry. So I glued the other one, so by the time I'm gonna glue the page, it's already dry. So here, so I center it, and then I piece with my finger and I fold like this, okay? And then I glue the other side. Again, with my glue. And then glue it. And I'm gonna do this process with all the pages, okay? Okay, to decorate the pages, I decided to cut a piece of paper that is 4 inch by 4 and a half. So I put it like this in, you know, you can put it whatever you want. I want to create pockets, but I don't want it to create many of them, and I don't want it to create the whole page pocket. So I decided to cut this square 4 by 4 and a half, and then I position it where I want my pocket to be. So then I draw a line, as you can see here, and then I'm going to put glue all around that, without putting glue in the drawing that I just showed you, right? So let's see, I can do this in camera faster, because the problem is that the glue, it gets dry very, very fast. So I need to do this very, very fast. But if I pause the video, you will not be able to see what I'm doing. So I'm trying to do this the best way possible. All I want to create are like tap pockets, that's all. And I'm trying to use the glue and put it in those scallops, so my scallops are all very well glued together. So by the end of these pages, the pages are very, very thick, because it has 3 layers of cardstock in there. Okay, now I'm going to center it with the scallops. You see the scallops, and then it will center by itself. I just accommodate the scallops so I know that my page is centered, and then I just press, and I just turn it in the other side and press, so it will glue very nicely together. Now you see here, I left this page without done, so I could show you. I made the pocket in the bottom here, and then the next page I did it in the top. Then the next one in the bottom, and the next one in the top. So when I made the tags, it is, you know, jumping from bottom to top. But again, you can create pockets in the top, or you can do the whole page pocket. You know, it's already for whatever you want to do with it, how you want your mini album to look like, and all that stuff. So I will decorate my pages at the end. This is more like a base tutorial. So you see here, this is where my base is going to be. So you see that the spine is shorter than my book, but this part will show up in the back like this. You see, very pretty. So that's what I'm gonna do. Now I did create this cutout, and what I did was to create the same base, and just instead of putting the paper like this, the design paper was like in with the design paper in the back of the mat. So when the Cricut cut it, when you flip it, the design paper is in the front, in the other side, like this. So I'm going to glue this. Okay, so I put tape already in my whole piece, and now I'm going to try to center it the best possible way, because you know how it is when you are trying to center something on camera, it's not as easy. So yeah. Okay, so there it is. So for any imperfections, like you aren't able to center it very well, What I do is that I cut this stencil goal and then I frame it. So I will cover this any mistake that I do with the glue in the inside. So that is a one way to put it on. So you just with your score tool, you just press. Now the tape that I'm using super good. This is a carpet tape, and I got it in Walmart. It's very strong. It's very strong. It's carpet tape, and it's $4 only. Super cheap, and it's a lot. It's just that I'm running out already. Had to go for more. So now we are going to center our piece of the mini album. Remember the score lines here, we are going to center it inside the score lines and then center it, center it. Okay, there you see. And then we're gonna glue this to the album base, okay? We are going to glue it. So I'm going to use probably tape better. Yeah, I'm going to use tape to glue this. And I'm gonna put the tape in this base. Remember, this base is shorter than this. So if you put the tape in this one, it's going to show up in the outside, and you don't want that. So that's why it has to be in the inside. Now let me cut this better, the tape, because it cut like an. Okay. Remember to take those tapes out, your incisors. I tend to wash my incisors afterwards because to take all the tape residual from there. Okay, so I'm gonna put the other one. Okay, and then cut. Now here I play a little bit more here on this tape. Then gonna take it off. Let me put this aside. Okay. You see the residual there of the tape? Okay, now I'm going to center this. Remember, you write pages in the right place, and then you're going to center it in with the edges of this, the corners of the album. Think I got it right? And then you just press. And then you open the pages and press and press. And press. Then we put a design paper and we start decorating. Now we have our base of the mini album. We have mini album here. As you can see, I'm going to put another strip of gold cardstock in here to cover this carton piece in here, like in the back. And this is the spine. You can put a shaker if you want to. Sorry, I moved the camera. You can put your shaker here, and I'm going to do that as well. You just have to glue it in there. I'm going to glue it in top of this. You can use the cutout part that I put in my file, and you can use this and put it like this and create a shaker, and then glue the shaker in there. But I want this to showcase, so that's why I did it like this. So I'm going to put it like this and use my goodies and everything and put glue the shaker in here, and it will look all pretty and all of that. Now it's just decoration. I already showed you how to put the shaker and all of the pages and everything. So yes, so I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, that it was Super, super fun to make. And I thank you so much for watching. I know it's a long video, but again, a tutorial on a mini album is going to always be a long video. And I wanted to explain everything very well so you don't get any confusion. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comments and I will answer back to you. So yeah, so take care. Have a wonderful day. Again, the link will be in the description box below. Thank you so much for watching and have a wonderful day. Thank you. Bye.